In the very near future, we're told, AI systems are going to take over most human endeavors, most human professions, including the healthcare profession. And there are some reports about AI being more effective in making diagnoses, finding treatments for patients, and solving patient challenges a whole lot more quickly and effectively than your normal trained physician. There are other reports about AI having better bedside manner than most doctors, for what it's worth. That being said, it seems like it could be a likely possibility that AI will take over many of the aspects of the healthcare profession. Now that seems pretty hunky-dory, right? It seems like you'll have a chatbot, maybe something looking a little bit more presentable, to consult, to show your condition, consult about your condition with, find the right diagnosis, find the right treatment, and follow up. It'll be much cheaper than actually getting out of bed, going to see the doctor in the clinic. It'll be much cheaper than actually paying the doctor because you can get it online, supposedly for free. And it'll be much more quick because you'll be getting those responses in a matter of seconds, maybe minutes, but not the exorbitant amount of time it takes for you to actually get out of the house, go to the doctor's office, check in at the doctor's front desk, sit in the room waiting for the doctor, consulting with the doctor. That takes a significant amount of time and effort on the average patient. So AI seems like a very quick and cost-effective solution to healthcare. What's wrong with that? Well, as you know me, I like to take a harder look at things. There are obvious glaring omissions or oversights regarding the possibility of AI taking over the healthcare profession. And by the way, I actually think taking over any other human endeavor or profession, I don't think that AI is a very good solution to take over these things, and I'll tell you why. Besides the fact that I obviously am biased, I am a physician, I love working with my patients, I love helping people find solutions to problems they may have had for a very short period of time, or you can have patients who have been wondering for a while, trying to find solutions for their problems, that eventually they get to the right doctor, that doctor helps them find a solution to their problem and makes the quality of their lives much better. Those are immensely satisfying prospects. But my love and my satisfaction in my own profession are not good enough reasons for having AI bow out to cater to me or to other physicians. Where are the problems with having AI manage healthcare and provide healthcare? Well, there's several issues. One is, consider this, if AI indeed takes over healthcare and replaces physicians and other healthcare professionals such as nurse practitioners and physician assistants, ultimately what you'll end up having is a monopoly or an oligopoly of AI bots that'll provide these services to the patients or the consumers. It only stands to reason that that's what's going to happen. You have a few major players in the market. They're heavily funded. They will clear out all the other competitors either by buying them out or having them go bankrupt. And eventually you'll have a few chatbots that will provide those services or whatever form the AI takes, either a chatbot or either something that's a little bit more presentable. Like I said, a humanoid AI device. Those are still going to belong to a few large corporations, much like the situation we have nowadays with social media in Silicon Valley. So you'll have a few chatbots monopolizing the entire industry, and there won't be much of a choice. Suppose you don't like your interaction with Green AI, which is one of the few players in the market. You want to go and try Purple AI, you don't like that either. And then you go to Yellow AI, you don't like that either. And what are you left with? You don't really have too many options after that. So you will have to pick and choose from a very select few options in the field. And those are what you're going to be living with. In contrast, in the medical professional, you can always pick and choose your healthcare provider. You don't like your doctor, your current doctor, you can always pick up and leave, go to the next one, seek a second opinion. And there are virtually, to the average human being, a much broader selection of healthcare providers to choose from. So you can always move on to the next provider. And once you strike up a good relationship with one that works for you, you can stick with that person. Or you can always pick up and leave. There's always another option for you to choose from. With an AI oligopoly or monopoly, there won't be that. Now, okay, suppose that you actually have an AI that performs a service that no other doctor can provide. What is wrong with having an AI oligopoly or monopoly, I say? So that is actually a pretty legitimate question to ask. Well, let's look at what happens with oligopolies and monopolies. What they do is, once they are in charge, they corner the market. This is actually pretty evident in the case of social media giants. They do not allow any new players to come into the picture. When they do come into the pictures, they're summarily escorted out of the arena. They're not allowed to take hold and to actually establish their business. And those very large corporations can always outdrown and outplay and outperform the smaller competitors just by pouring money at the problem, suing them out of existence, or engaging in other behaviors that are monopolistic and predatory. So you will not have anything else to really go for after AI takes over. But that means that you will end up with services that are monopolistic, and that means that they will be the ones calling the shots. There's no free market at the monopoly or oligopoly stage to really dictate to the players, to the businesses that are providing these services, how to behave and how to conduct themselves. That is up to those monopoly businesses. If they're the only players in town, if there's only AI healthcare, and there's no human providers to be found because they've all gone out of business and moved on to other professions, all their wisdom, their experience, their knowledge, all of these faculties that they used to use to provide healthcare, those are long gone and lost. You're only left with those monopolistic corporations providing AI services at their discretion, on a whim, to their pleasure, and at your expense. Now, cornering the market. Right now, you're seeing AI services that are virtually free of charge. You're not paying a whole lot to use AI on the internet, maybe nothing, maybe a little bit of a premium to get your premium, your upgrade service. But suppose that AI services are the only ones providing healthcare, and those are the only players in town. What stops those organizations or those companies from jacking up the prices once they've cornered the market? I'd say not a whole lot. And we'll get to the next problem at the end of it, which really makes for a very big, scary proposition. Now, the interesting thing about AI bots, and I've used them quite a lot in the past few months and experimented with them, is that they are not infallible. First of all, they are programmed by human beings, and those human beings made a point to program those services with certain biases. They don't want the AI bots telling jokes about this demographic, but they can't allow them to talk about this demographic. They have programmed the AI to discriminate between people based on their immutable characteristics and their assigned group identity per the developers of the software. So that AI is inherently biased against human beings based on some arbitrary criteria that the programmers or developers set, and that is inherent to the system. So you as a person belonging to a certain demographic can't expect to get some sort of biased treatment from the AI based on those criteria, which are arbitrarily set by the developers and are reinforced by the algorithm itself. Another thing that's very interesting is that AI algorithms are not incorruptible. They're not without their inherent problems. And there are certain glaring issues with AI software, with the AI algorithms, that are apparent in the real world to many people experimenting with these applications, as well as the developers themselves that have sounded the alarm about these things. For instance, AI algorithms can suffer from issues such as data drift, concept drift, adversarial attacks, bias and fairness issues, as I've mentioned earlier, hardware and software aging, which is inherent to any computer system being used by AI, is not immune to that either, lack of maintenance, which is another issue. These systems require consistent upkeep and updates to make sure they're up to date and are consistent in their work, analysis, and maintenance of knowledge banks. There's such a concept in the AI world known as catastrophic forgetting, where an AI algorithm completely forgets a concept that's previously been mastered, and that's being tossed by the wayside. And then AI can suffer from external problems, such as adverse attacks by hackers and other players that are not quite sympathetic to the AI algorithm, that can actually affect its efficacy and direction. And then there are other external issues, such as power supply connectivity and hardware issues. And then there are regulatory changes imposed by legislatures to curb or to change or modify or regulate the work of AI. All these things can actually influence the performance of the chatbot with which you're engaging for either a mundane task or for healthcare purposes or any other critical task in your life. And that can severely affect the efficacy, the direction, and the quality of advice or consultation you'll be getting through an AI chatbot. I'm sure that all these are technical glitches that can probably, with enough work and enough effort, can be actually addressed and fixed, at least to an extent. What is not fixable, and this is likely going to happen once AI bots and their parent companies take over, corner any market, is complete and utter lack of accountability. What do I mean by that? Well, suppose that these AI oligopolies or monopolies have cornered the AI market. They're now in charge of the entire industry, and those are the only applications or the only service providers you can turn to. Suppose an AI bot, with all its fallibility, and they are fallible, by the way, makes a mistake or treats you the wrong way or is malfunctioning for whatever reason. Who is it that you're going to hold accountable exactly? Now, I guess that the natural response would be the company that owns the AI service. But when was the last time an individual, a private citizen, was able to sue and hold any big tech company accountable? The answer is probably never. Now look at the money, the resources, and the time that governments around the world, such as the EU, the Australian government, the Canadian government, the US federal government, are spending on taking big tech giants to court. Those lawsuits take many years to process and to see through. They take likely many billions of dollars to see through on both sides, by the way, but no earthly human being commands that much power to take someone to task to court. And when you're dealing with a monopoly that corners such a critical aspect of individual life, you are really left defenseless against a system that basically will do with you as it pleases, with the faulty algorithms, maybe even with intentional bias programmed against you, and then you will have no one to answer to in case anything goes wrong. That is one of the major reasons why I think implementing AI in the healthcare profession should be done extremely carefully. Because imagine a situation where you have basically zero choices for healthcare provision. The market is completely cornered, meaning it can be made extremely expensive. And on top of that, the service you will receive may not be the best service. You will not have any other options to turn to. And in case something goes wrong, you will have no one to talk to, literally. If you've liked this video, share, like, and subscribe. Put a comment in the comments section. Thank you for watching this video, and God bless.